That's recording.
Okay.
Sweet.
We're now live. So who are you?
Hang on.
Okay, no worries.
Don't want my glasses to be all smudged.
Oh, yeah.
He was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home to a place he'd never been before. He left yesterday behind him. You might say he was born again. You might say he found the key for every door. When he first came to the mountains, his life was far away. On the road, hanging by a song. But the string's already broken, and he doesn't really care. It keeps changing fast, and it don't last for long. If the Colorado Rocky Mountain High, I've seen it rain and fire.
I'm Richard Lautze, known as Richard at the school, and I've taught at the urban school since 1981. Oh, urban has changed tremendously, but thinking about it, I think something that's alive changes all the time, and I think urban school has been a very alive place. I asked immediately if I could teach Cal Studies, and they said, hold on, you have to be here at the school for a while, and there are other people who teach Cal Studies, but I saw this class called California Studies, so I had to wait for 6 years to get into Cal Studies, but I made a proposal at that point and said I could teach a class on water, and I got to do it. It fit very well to be the outdoor trips coordinator and the Cal Studies teacher. And I could drive the bus. So I knew right from the beginning I was going to go after those things. And it just worked out. I've seen it rain and fire in the sky. Talk to God and listen to the casual reply. Cal Studies, at that point, when I got to do it, it was a 6-week class at the end of the year, and it was the only class that students had. So that 6 weeks, we left, we were off campus. We since it was the only class students had, we took 3 or 4 trips. So we'd leave on Monday or Tuesday, come back on Friday, leave the next Tuesday, come back on Friday, and then leave Tuesday and come back 2 weeks later. So we traveled a lot. What happened is I learned California Studies by doing that. I taught with a gentleman named Alan Ridley, who was a field biologist and brilliant person in the field. And he taught me a lot about California. So Alan was one of the founders of Cal Studies. Alan and I worked closely together, and then we did water. And then we realized, hey, we should do forestry. And then we did energy. And then we did agriculture. And so basically the urban school allowed me to have this class where I got to say, I want to learn about agriculture. And I brought 18 students with me. And what a gift for me. It was a gift. When I call people on the phone and I say I have a group of interested students who would like to learn something, they're going to open, they open the door for us because I'm a teacher. So I've used that ticket to get into places that other people can't get into. And initially the San Francisco Water Department showed us everything. It was an open door. They would give me keys to some places so we could go in without supervision. what I have understood about California, it's a very complex place. A tremendous amount of diversity in California. And it's not easy to undo some of the things that have been done. And it's not easy to understand why some of the things were done. And then when you meet people, it's even more disarming because people working in the field, maybe doing things that I disagree with, are very good people. And they're doing what they believe in. So that makes it even more challenging to condemn the practices that they have when you realize where their heart is and what they're trying to do.
I'm Danny Kelly, Robert Daniel Kelly III. My family's been here for 7 generations. I like to think of us as stewards of the land, you could say almost. It's our responsibility to keep the business going because that was number one. My family didn't settle here to, just to be here, it was a business, yeah. And it expanded from there. But we have to be responsible for that. It is a hard balance, though. It is a hard balance, but it's our actions that let us, make that right.
I am charged with protecting life and property as president of the Reclamation District. I have a charge to do my job. People pay their assessments for that purpose, not for me to go play around with flora and fauna.
Any district you talk to, it's all about water. Okay, so any farmer you talk to, it's all about water. Farmers are scared that they're going to lose their water rights. Farmers are scared that the state is going to shut down their wells to where they'll be out of business. A lot of farmers that you talk to in this area will tell you that California is pushing them out. And one of the ways to push them out is just to make it harder on them. And one of the main ways is to take water away from them. So it's a very touchy issue. But yeah, I truly feel, and a lot of people feel, water is the new gold in California.
I just appreciated the opportunity to meet with people and hear from them. And so over the years, I guess I have developed some beliefs that I think are true, but I have to check it all the time. And that's what I love about being with urban school students, because they help me check my knowledge all the time.
Hi, my name is Kira Waldman, and I am Cal Studies in Urban School class of 2016, but really I am living out Cal Studies every day. One thing I love about Richard, and that has helped me as I become an educator and just a scientist as well, is the passion he brings for new understanding. So Richard could have read the same book or listened to the same song 1,000 times, but every time he brings it to a new student, he has a nuanced excitement and a new vision, and he really allows his students to engage with work in ways that we find interesting to us, and then continues to evoke more passion because of his passion and his stoke.
To me, I think that's what urban school is about, this pursuit of learning, realizing that there's no end to that. There's no end to it. The more you know, the more you know you don't know, and the more there is to learn.
He loves urban and he loves students, and his Beyond Your Imagination just reflects all the love and commitment he's given to the school all these years, and it comes from his real fundamental belief in educating teenagers, loving teenagers, believing in teenagers.
I'll just tell you that my passion is California Studies. I've lived here my whole life. I've lived in Bay Area most of my life. I lived in Davis for a little while. I lived in the Sierras for a little while. But it's a fascinating place, and what I learned in California Studies can also, I realize it can be transported to any part of the world.
From his work, like I said, at Urban, in outdoor trips, in math, supporting athletics, his work with AIM High, founding the outdoor program out at in the Headlands at Tennessee Valley. He's just an amazing and gifted educator, and it's been my privilege to work with him.
Richard, I am beyond impacted by your incredible career at the Urban School, and so excited for this next chapter for you, and good luck on retirement, and thank you for everything, from the basketball court, to the classroom, to the backpacking trails. You truly are a rock star.
And if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, where the landslide bring you down. And if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, where the landslide bring you down.